Taking things in an entirely different direction, the developers chose to set Metal Gear Solid 3 in the past, at the roots of the Metal Gear legacy. The prequel would take into account real-world tensions at the height of the Cold War in the early 1960s. Once again, players would be in control of someone other than Solid Snake and would instead play as Naked Snake, a CIA operative that is sent into the jungles of Russia with his mentor, a female super spy codenamed The Boss. In the prologue mission, The Boss defects and teams up with the chief antagonist in the story, Colonel Volgin. After an intense fight, The Boss leaves Naked Snake badly wounded as she and Volgin make off with a stolen nuclear super tank and a predecessor to the Metal Gear called the Shagohod. After healing, Naked Snake is sent back into the jungle to defeat Volgin, confront the Boss, and destroy the tank. To do this, Snake must face the members of the Boss's Cobra unit. Many gamers have called these characters the greatest collection of bosses in the entire franchise. The End is an expert sniper that fights Snake in a long-range, protracted battle that can literally take hours. The Fear is a spider-like adversary with double-jointed limbs and a surgically enhanced tongue. The Fury is a former Russian cosmonaut who battles Snake with a flamethrower. The Pain has the ability to command hornets and uses them to combat Snake. The Sorrow, a spirit medium, is perhaps the most interesting of all the bosses in the game because he employs the power of the dead to fight Snake.
You are walking through, you know, this stream and you're seeing these dead soldiers and you're like, okay, dead soldiers. And then you start to notice, like, wait a second, these are the ghosts of the people that I've killed. It makes you look back on what you've already done and sort of see it in a different way, like, wow, I've really killed like a lot of people. Like if this was real life, I would be, you know, completely haunted.
From beginning to end, Metal Gear Solid 3 is the near perfect prequel, setting up the events and characters that would follow it beautifully. Metal Gear Solid 3 also helped to define and cement the status of Kojima Productions as world-class game makers. The team had expertly shown how to get the most out of the PlayStation 2 hardware and had the sales and the critical praise to prove it.
I'd never played through all of the Metal Gear games, so I had what I called the Metal Gear Summer, and I played through 1, 2, and 3 back-to-back. I didn't play anything else, and it was the best summer I had ever had.
But would the team be able to contend with another PlayStation console transition? Kojima Productions' toughest challenges lay ahead as the team faced the limitless potential and the baffling technological puzzles of the brand new PlayStation 3.
Yeah, I think the whole Metal Gear series has been a huge part of the PlayStation success. The Metal Gear games, I mean, from the Psycho Mantis battle to the Jeep chase at the end of Metal Gear 1 to the opening of Metal Gear 2 on the bridge to, you know, the torture sequences that sort of live in all the games. It really is almost like an action movie art film.
Kojima-san が、そうですね、業界に残した功績っていうのは本当たくさんあると思うんですけれども、僕が一番実感するのは作ってる立場からの視点なんですけれども、ゲームにとって物語がどれだけ重要かっていうのと、それからゲームにとって重厚なシナリオっていうものがどれだけ価値のあるものかっていうものをやはり小島さんは本当ゲームの中で、知らしめたのかな。
The announcement and development of Metal Gear Solid 4 Guns of the Patriots represented a new era for Kojima Productions, as polished storytellers versed both in cinematic flair and dynamic gameplay. The new platform from Sony offered the experienced game makers the opportunity to dream big.
ボスのキャラクターの特殊な動きをするもの、触手がついているものとか、あとその犬みたいな格好で走り回ったりするものとかがあったりしたんで、そういうのは結構全部手付けで作ってたので大変でしたね。
メタルギアソリッドっていうゲームが一番最初にできた時のからのなんていうか思想みたいなものはずっと受け継がれてきてる。で、それが今もまだちゃんと残ってる。
With each subsequent release of a Metal Gear Solid 4 trailer, the world grew more and more excited by the promising look of the game. Was this the Sony PlayStation 3's most important game on the horizon? To many, it certainly looked that way.
Metal Gear Solid 1の時は、例えるならば、こう草野球、子供たちが野原で集まって、やってるような野球に比べて、今のもう Metal Gear Solid 4は大リーグのベースボールのような、大きさになっています。もちろん、観客も随分と 増えましたので、それなりに、責任を感じて、責任を重く肩に背負いながら、作っています。
プレイヤーが、こうしたらどうなるんだろうとか、こうしてみたいなということをほぼ全て網羅してるというか、遊びの幅を広く持つことで、その世界の中で何ができるかなっていうふうに思ったユーザーにがっかりさせないというか。
Cutscenes from previous Metal Gear games, as artful as they were, don't hold a candle to the new look and feel of Metal Gear Solid 4, which delivers imagery as close to reality as the team has ever come.
キーワードとなるのがカメラの手ブレ、ハンディカメラで撮ってるのが手ブレ感、やっぱこれが一番重要なんですよ。今回ちょっとツールを改良しまして、ある程度その自動的に手ブレがつくような、そういう機構を考えました。
Expectations from gamers and from the team itself were very high. The work involved in bringing this game to the PlayStation 3 was immense. The team size at Kojima Productions had swelled considerably, and the pressure was getting to Hideo Kojima.
プレステ3というか、まあ次世代のマシンなんですけど、非常に作らないといけないものが多すぎですね。大変です。ハリウッドの映画っぽい作り方に、まあ、現状なってます。ライン性というかで、今回はプレイステーション3で、作るものも当然増えたんですけど、ボリュームも非常にあって、なおかつ、これが一番大きいんですけど、チーム員が、一番多い時で200人ぐらいいますので、200人対1人ということなんで非常に大変です。それが一番辛いですね。
小島監督のビジョンがとにかく大きいスケールなので、それを実現させるために、その人に関してもそのプロジェクト自体も大きくなる。でそれはもうメタルギアソリッドっていうゲームに対して、そのたくさんのファンが待ってくれているからできたことでもあると思うんですけれども、
ここがちょっとこう悲しいことでもありますよね。ストレスがたまるのが一番そこです。
The plan for the game was an epic send-off for Solid Snake and an end to his decades-long saga.
I'd have to say old Snake's mental state is pretty ragged. Now he's deteriorating badly, and he's really paid quite a price for his dedication to his country and to his job.
The epic scale of the game meant that this time Kojima and his team would travel the world looking for appropriate locations for the most dramatic of confrontations. Sticking with his prescient ability to pick up on global concerns about the military-industrial complex, Kojima focused the narrative on the growing influence of private military corporations. Metal Gear Solid 4 brings back familiar faces that have come and gone over the franchise's long lifetime, and the developers worked hard to come to a fitting conclusion for the series.
Saga の、最終作と完結編なので、今まで出てきたキャラクターをですね、みんな幸せにしたいという思いがありまして、なるべく出しましたね。で、彼らがどこに向かっていくのかっていうのも、方法をやっていただけるとわかると思います。
But is this really the end for Solid Snake?
僕の中で、メタルギアソリッドの、ソリッドスネークサーガと言われるものはこれで終わりにしたいです。スネークもおじさんになったし疲れたんで、次メタルギアは当然あると思います。メタルギアっていうシリーズは続いていくと思うんですけども、それはソリッドスネークとは違う、もっとフレッシュな新しいキャラクターとか新しい世界観とか新しい物語を紡いでいった方がいいと思います。
In its 20 years, Metal Gear has touched millions of lives. There are fans of this series from all corners of the world. Snake and his co-stars have entered video game and popular culture with tremendous style and will forever be linked to the birth of the stealth action genre.
It was the first.
It's definitely a landmark series in video game history.
やっぱりステルスアクションに尽きるのかなと。
Will we see more Metal Gear games? Or has this series retired along with Solid Snake? Don't give up looking under suspicious cardboard boxes just yet.